Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Christina and in today's video, I am going to be doing a mini review of the Rough and Tumble pillow bag. I have been admiring this bag for many, many months now. I have a few friends on Instagram that do have this bag that have spoken so highly about it that I finally decided to take the plunge and purchase this bag. And you guys, it is really awesome. So the particular design that I have is a limited edition. I think they still have it in stock. I will link it down below, but it is a limited edition. So this particular style, color, everything won't be on the website for long. So this is the Sahara Mel leather. That's like the body of the bag. And it has a rolled top, meaning that you see some of the like leather here in the on the top and the inside on the outside. So it kind of gives a little bit of interest to the bag itself. And I don't know if you can tell. Oh, there we go. It is a snake print, which I think looks really cool. The strap is in their distressed tusk leather, which is beautiful. And this is an adjustable strap. Something that really surprised me is the pictures on the website make the bag look bigger than it actually is. Don't get me wrong, it is a big bag, but I've seen bigger. And for some reason, on the website, it looks massive. So this is the regular size, the original size. There is a small, and I almost got the small, but I'm glad that I didn't, because I do, when I go out, I like to put my son's stuff in here as well. And it's just like the perfect size for both of us. So the dimensions, I have it written down. So the height going this way is 13 inches. The width is 17 inches. So from here to here, it's 17 inches. The depth, so let me pull up the bottom here so you can take a look, is a nice and roomy 7 inches. And then the opening up at the top, I'm not sure how they measure it, but it's 14.5 inches. I'm assuming that's circumference. I'm not really sure, but I got that from the website. So, it's a very spacious bag. I am a person that likes to carry a lot of things, so I'm glad I went with the original size because it is just the right amount of room for me. Let's talk a little bit about the inside. So there is going to be a D-ring that is for your key fob if you want to use it. So that is there, and it also is detachable. So this, I believe, does come out. Yep. You can click that out and take this off, which I will probably do. I find that I never really use those D-ring straps. And the pocket configuration, which is something that I really like about this bag, is great. So here in the back, and I'll do a down review so you can take a look, but here in the back, we do have a long zipper pocket. On either side, there is going to be like a half pocket. This is hard to do this way. Well, basically there's four of those type of slip pockets. So you can put a water bottle in there. I put my water bottle, my son's water bottle in there. I end up putting snacks and all the other pockets. It's just great. And so on the interior, this lining that comes with this particular bag is called Pichelin, I believe. It's a beautiful kind of like olive green color that really, I think, goes really well with the actual Sahara leather. Now, the Sahara leather is, on the website, they call it their most exquisite leather. I'm not really sure what that means. It must be like the finest leather they have in stock. And this particular color is called Sahara. I'm sorry, Mel is the type of leather. Sahara is the color. And the way they described it is not to be matte, but not shiny in the leather. And there's no real way to describe it, but it is just that. It's not particularly shiny and it's not matte. It's just like right in between. It's beautiful. It has a very even grain. If you get closer, you will see that it is like butter. It is so soft and smooth. There is no like texture to it, which is really nice and luxurious looking. And it's very silky. It's a very silky leather, which is really pretty. Let's see. What else did I forget to mention? Oh, so I have a magnetic closure on this one. It does, I think some of the pillows are offered with a actual zipper closure, but this one is magnetic, which is fine. I'm in and out of my bag all the time, so I don't need it to be closed to have a closure like that. This particular pillow has exposed zips on the side. So these are very roomy pockets on the side here. And this is where I've been carrying my phone and my AirPods, just here on the side. And actually, yesterday, I left it open and I put my son's water bottle in there so that I could pull it in and out really easily. I really like the exposed zipper look. I know that you can get one that has a little bit of a flap so that you don't see the zipper, but I really like the interest that the zipper gives to the overall look of the bag. What else? The hardware on it, which is, there's not very much, but like on the zippers and stuff, they refer to as antique silver. So it's kind of got a matte finish to it, and it's not particularly bright, which I like. And what else? Did I mention this is an adjustable strap? So this fits over my shoulder, but you can pull it, make it longer, and also make it into a crossbody bag, which is great for this mama because she needs to be hands-free sometimes. And having a crossbody bag just makes that easier. I have only had this bag for about 2 weeks now, so there's not much to say in terms of wear and tear. I'm happy to do a review on this bag again in about 6 months or so after I've used it a little bit more so that I can give you a better review of wear and tear on the leather and of the structure of the bag. But I can tell you right now that I think she is gorgeous. I think that she is very underrated. I have found that there are a lot of people that have like the hobo bag, I think it's called the safari bag. There's like a bunch of different types of bags that Rough and Tumble makes, and I find that the pillow is probably one of their most underrated. But I think this is even better than the hobo because I actually had the hobo bag, and I think the make of this is just, it's stunning. I really like it. And it's functional. So, all right, so that was my mini review of this bag. If you guys have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. I also know that you can do a custom design, so you can pick anything from the exposed zipper to widening or making the strap narrower. You can choose the leather. You can do all of that stuff on roughandtumble.com. I highly recommend checking that out, which I might do. I might get a custom because this is awesome. All right. So if you guys have any questions, please don't hesitate to comment down below, or you can follow me on Instagram at the Miss Mrs. Mom and DM me there as well. All right. I hope you guys enjoyed, and until next time, see ya.